Hi, everybody. Welcome back to the front room. I'm Khan. I'm here with my dad today.
Hi everybody, thanks for joining us.
Today, I'm excited for today, not just because of the song, but because what the song will allow us to do in the future, almost. So,
It's a stepping stone.
it's a major stepping stone.
Okay.
It's a major stepping stone in one of actually the biggest rapper of all time's career.
Biggest rapper of all time. I know that's a hint. I'm supposed to respond with a guess or two.
Well, you can guess.
Biggest rapper of all
In terms of
time,
sales.
Kanye.
No.
It wouldn't be Kendrick because he hasn't been around for that long. Eminem.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
We
All
come,
right.
yeah.
Yeah. We did
Rock bottom.
Rock Bottom. I really like that song.
That was that's a great one.
That was really good.
But
I
that
actually
one.
I haven't gone back and listened. I listened to it after we did the reaction, but I haven't heard it since then. Yeah.
Yeah, that was a great one. But this is a completely other side, the side that most people remember him for at the
Okay.
time
All right.
in 1999 when the first his first album released. Well, his first sort of studio album, I'll say, because he had one prior. But this is his breakout album. So the song I'm showing you today is called My Name Is.
Doesn't ring a bell.
No?
No.
That's amazing. Okay, I was wondering. So My Name Is produced by Dr. Dre.
Oh,
And
I
Eminem,
didn't know.
they
Well,
worked.
why would I know one way or the other? But I didn't know that those guys teamed up.
Well, I think Dr. Dre has become one of Eminem's greatest friends, and likewise. And they met around this time, and My Name Is was the first song they ever recorded together. And in fact, Dr. Dre, when he was going to meet up with Eminem after finding out about his music, thought didn't even know that he was white.
No, you're kidding me.
Yeah. So they met up, and
Oh.
Eminem was so scared to meet Dr. Dre, he didn't even look at him in the eyes. And Dr. Dre thought, like, what's up with this kid, you know? But it was just because
This
he was
timid
just so
kid.
nervous
Yeah.
to work with a legend, right?
Yeah.
And their very first studio session, the very first second of Eminem recording, he came up with the main chorus of the song.
Eminem did.
Yeah, and this is his like big breakout song,
Oh,
and it was created just like that
jeez.
in the beginning.
Quick question. If he had only released something, what did you say? Like a
Yeah, he
prior, something
released
prior. Anyway, he hadn't released much.
No, he released an EP, and then I think
Okay.
he released an album in
But
1996
at this
when he
point,
was independent, pretty much.
I see. At this point, though, Dr. Dre was well established.
Yes.
So I
This is
wonder,
10 years after
yeah.
NWA's album.
Yeah, so why would Dr. Dre want to work with this
He
nobody
heard
of sorts?
a demo, Eminem's demo, or yeah, Eminem's demo, and he never heard a demo that had interested him
Oh,
before,
okay.
prior to this. So he's like, you know, this is the first one that has ever made me feel like this. And legend has it that Dr. Dre found this demo on the gym floor of, or I think Interscope Records, some big person in that for that record company had Eminem's demo just like lying around on the gym floor or something like that, and he picked it up
Yeah.
and listened to it.
Oh, wow. Yeah, because they must get lots of demos submitted, I guess, to them.
And
And
if it wasn't for Dr. Dre, Eminem wouldn't have gotten as big as
yeah,
he did.
certainly not as early anyway.
Yeah, or at all possibly. So this is a really important song for Eminem's career. And it will help give you sort of a picture of Eminem that I don't know if you really, a shocking picture of
Well, I've
Eminem.
heard. Obviously, I've heard the one song I
Rock
reacted to,
Bottom.
and then I've heard probably three or four other Eminem songs that I may recognize if I were to hear them again, but I can't think of any particular rap phrase or any of
Yeah.
the music or anything like
Okay,
that. Yeah.
nice. So this is My Name Is. I have the lyrics up for you.
My name is.
And this is off of the Slim Shady LP, which released in 1999. Same album as Rock Bottom. This was the second single for the album. His
Okay.
first single was Just Don't Give a Fuck.
Oh.
And this is, yeah, this is My Name Is.
Okay.
Hi, my name is.
Hi.
My name is.
Slim Shady.
Hi, my name is.
Hi.
My name is.
What?
My name is. 1 second. My name is Hi kids, do you like violence? Yeah, wanna see me stick 9-inch nails to each one of my eyelids? Wanna copy me and do exactly like I did? Sit and get fucked up worse than my life is? My brain's dead weight. I'm trying to get my head straight, but I can't figure out which Spice Girl I want to impregnate. And Dr. Dre said,
Slim Shady, you a basic. Why's your face red? Man, you wasted.
Well, since age 12, I felt like I'm someone else, because I hung my original self from the top bunk with a belt. Got pissed off and ripped Pamela Lee's tits off and smacked her so hard I knocked her clothes backwards like Chris Paul. I smoke a fat pound of grass and fall on my ass faster than a fat bitch who sat down too fast. Come here, slut. Shady, wait a minute. That's my girl, dawg. I don't give a fuck. God sent me to piss the world off. Hi, my name is what? My name is
I didn't realize that 2000 this is?
1999.
Yeah, I didn't realize there was a lot of some humor in rap of this.
Well, he's the first one to really bring it in this way.
Is he?
Yeah. It's very shocking. That's why the song got big.
The lyrics were shocking.
Yeah.
Yeah.
My English teacher wanted to flunk me in junior high. Thanks a lot. Next semester, I'll be 35. I smacked him in his face with an eraser. Chased him with a stapler. Stapled his nuts to a stack of paper. Walked in a strip club. Had my jacket zipped up. Blast a bartender. And stuck my dick in a tip cup. Extraterrestrial. Running over pedestrians in a spaceship while they screaming at me. Let's just be friends. 99% of my life I was lied to. I just found out my mom does more dope than I do. I told her I'd grow up to be a famous rapper. Make a record about doing drugs and name it after. You know you blew up when the women rush your stands. Try to touch your hands.
I like that background. That just came in. It sort of filled the space a bit.
Yeah. So this main chorus, Dr. Dre put in the tape just of a beat he made. And Eminem put the headphones on, started rapping. And he just said this. And then they just ran with it. They made it with, Dr. Dre said they made the whole song within seconds. That's what he said.
Wow.
Stop the tape. This kid needs to be locked away.
Get him.
Dr. Dre, don't just stand there. Operate. I'm not ready to leave. It's too scary to die. I'll have to be carried inside the cemetery and buried alive.
Yep.
Am I coming or going? I can barely decide. I just drank a fifth of vodka. Dare me to drive?
Go ahead.
All my life I was very deprived. I ain't had a woman in years, and my palms are too hairy to hide.
Whoops.
Clothes ripped like the Incredible Hulk. I spit when I talk. I fuck anything that walks.
Come here.
When I was little, I used to get so hungry I would throw fits. How you gonna breastfeed me, mom? You ain't got no tits. I lay awake and strap myself in the bed with a bulletproof vest on and shoot myself in the head.
Bang.
I'm steaming mad. And by the way, when you see my dad,
yeah,
tell him that I slit his throat in this dream I had. My name is what? My name is what? My name is
Chicken Slim Shady.
My name is what? My name is
what?
My name is
Chicken Slim Shady.
So can you tell this is Dr. Dre during the production? Is it, does it have his flavor? Can you tell? Or
it has that sort of Christmas,
yeah.
Crispness with the drums.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Man, this can't compare to the other Eminem song we did.
Yeah.
What was the name of it again?
Rock Bottom.
Oh, man, that was so good. This is tongue-in-cheek.
Yeah.
Right? So there's humor in it. I get that. Some of the humor is kind of funny. But everything about it, to me, is kind of straightforward. A little too straightforward for my taste, maybe.
Yeah.
You know? I'd have to put myself back then to know how much of a landmark this song might have been. Like, to me, compared to the rap we've listened to,
yeah,
this is very underwhelming. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But
yeah, I mean,
so give me some help here to appreciate it.
Well, the thing, I definitely, well, I listened to this when I got into rap.
Did you? Yeah.
Because Eminem is just such a, he's just captivating in a really, I don't know, in a strange way.
Uh-huh.
You know, he gets your attention.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And he has the technical ability, but he's also just wacky.
Mm-hmm.
Like
mm-hmm.
this. So for a 10-year-old me, this was very, very interesting to listen to.
So does this song, though, does this song...
About 10, but maybe after that.
A little bit after. I hope you weren't listening to this at 10.
Well, I didn't even know what they were talking about when I was 10. You know?
Right.
It's like, what...
Who's this guy named Dick?
Like, I just hear these bad words, but I don't have any meaning towards them. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
So it's just... Sure. Yeah. But
from a technical side, rapping point of view, this seems... Maybe I'm missing something. It seems very simple to me.
It is pretty simple. There's just
I've heard some Eminem, like I said, and some of it, I mean, it's like, wow.
Mm-hmm. Right? Yeah, and he was doing some more technical stuff at this time, even if you go back to 1996.
Was he? Okay.
And I think it was 96 when he released his sort of project called Infinite.
Mm-hmm.
That's basically just a song where he fit as many rhymes and wordplay bits in as possible.
Yeah. I've heard him rapping super fast.
Yeah, that's right? That's also a trademark of his, especially later on.
Uh-huh.
But
oh, okay.
Yeah, he has the ability, but I mean, this is just him messing around.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
And he brings forward the Slim Shady character, obviously.
Slim Shady.
There you hear. My name is Slim Shady.
Mm-hmm.
Have you heard that name before?
I think so.
Mm-hmm.
I think probably.
Yeah. So Slim Shady is just sort of his alter ego that he plays for the whole album, basically. For most of the album, at least.
Okay. Okay.
And it's basically just a maniac on the loose looking for danger and violence and
character.
Doesn't have moral, compass or anything like that.
Right.
Lacks that.
Right.
So that's the Slim Shady character. And at the time, it's a character that is honestly pretty one-dimensional.
Yeah.
But it does, I don't know. I don't even know what to make of it now after I've listened to him for so long.
Yeah, and I know that you've delved into rap in quite a big way. So you've been exposed to all kinds of rap, right, through the years.
Yeah.
So I would think... that this to you now would seem very kind of ordinary, kind of.
Yeah, now it doesn't have any effect on me, really.
It doesn't.
But back then it did. Yeah. So I thought it might on you, but
yeah,
yeah, I think it just sounded, it's so simple and sort of funny sounding, even the beat.
Ba-dum, 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 ba-dum. Yeah, yeah.
It doesn't sound cool, you know.
No, not at all. No.
It sounds awkward almost.
Oh yeah,
I think
it's supposed to sound that
so
way,
that's where it stuck out. Sounded different as well.
Oh yeah, I could see how that would be because if, yeah, rap in those days was supposed to be really cool and kind of like gangsterish, right?
With yeah,
heavy driving beat a lot of the time, right?
Mm-hmm.
And along comes this.
Yeah,
yeah.
What what I think. Mm-hmm. I'm planning on showing you an Eminem album just to, you know, it's a necessary listen sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
There's this album to listen to, but then also one afterwards that I have right up there. That's the first vinyl record that I ever had, actually.
Oh, okay.
You bought it for me for Christmas, maybe 6 years ago.
Oh yeah, I remember.
So that's the one I like the most. Mm-hmm. And then there's also one after called The Eminem Show. So I want to show one of those, but there's one song from that album that I just want to show by itself. That it's sort of preparing you for.
Mm.
I just want to show you the character that Slim Shady is, because that song is about that character. And people just absolutely, you cannot, I mean, you lived during that time, but you didn't pay that much attention to like this stuff going on, to say the least, if you don't know this song. So
zero.
Yeah. So I just wanted to fill you in with that because it's necessary for showing you possibly his best song.
Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Children's Story that we listened to. Slick Rick. Rakim. All predated this, right?
But
they were late 80s.
By 10 years.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. Much better song.
Well, I'm sure a lot of our real hip-hop heads are fans will appreciate that.
Really?
Comment.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Because I know a lot of them, when they see this video, they're thinking, oh, God, this isn't good. But I just thought it was a necessary thing. So, anyways. Yeah.
Well, you know what? I want to be honest, right? I don't want to say, oh, this is wonderful, you know, if I don't like it, right?
Yeah, totally.
And I'm not saying I don't like it, but it just, like I said, I'm repeating myself, but compared to the other Eminem song we listened to, which was just really top notch.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, I hope to show you more of those. Because most of his stuff at this time was just like this.
Like this?
Yeah, like that.
Ooh,
yeah.
Okay.
A bit more clever,
yeah,
and not as simple as this, but nonetheless, he plays this Slim Shady character. So that's sort of him.
That's it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Anyways, thanks for...
No,
thanks
I'm
for
glad
listening.
You showed it to me. Mm-hmm. Awesome.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah, you're welcome. Well, thanks for watching, everybody. If you want to suggest some other Eminem songs, we will gladly take your suggestions. I'm familiar with basically his whole discography because he was
really?
Like my favorite rapper early on. And not anymore, but he still has some songs that are fantastic and even some albums. So, yeah. Anyways, thanks for watching, everybody.
Thanks for dropping in, guys. See ya.
See ya.